Greetings, y'all. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade, back playing some more Farming Simulator 17 here on Lawfolds. I've dropped the windrower and the mower here. It does a really good job of mowing and raking this up into one center pile here, so we can come back and either bale it or pick it up with a loading wagon. But we got another task at hand. We want to pick up our gold nuggets. There's one over there to the left. Actually, it's to our right, and there's more up ahead, so we're going to come out and get these gold nuggets. You can see them a lot better if you get in your vehicle and see, I saw some more over here. Yep, there they are. They're easier to see when you mow, too, so. We'll go pick these up. I didn't get that one, did I? Come on, 26. So, yeah, we definitely need our tractor here to see where they're at. Oh yeah, there's a bunch out in here. Let me get out and get these. There. There. I saw another one down here. Where'd it go? There it is. And there. There's some more up here in front of it. Right there. Oh, there's one. There's another one. We'll say this is a whole lot easier than picking them up on other maps. Whoever did this, thank you. Thank you very much. You know, I was probably in the episode where we first walked across this field going that way. I was probably passing them up left and right. And y'all are probably watching this saying, hey, there's gold, there's gold. Alright, I'm not seeing any. See, it's harder to see with the taller grass, so let me get back in my tractor. I think I saw one over here to the right of it. Didn't I? Or did I already pick it up? Maybe I already picked it up. Nope. It's right over there, right in front of the tractor somewhere. Am I crazy? Oh, there it is. See how hard they're covered up out here. That's okay, we've got our tractor. We'll find them all. Tell you what, I'm just going to drive up to each one of them, pick them up. There we go. Got it. Like I said, it's like an Easter egg hunt. Getting close to Easter here. Springtime here at Lawfolds. Getting our Easter eggs out here. Alright, I think I can get... Boy, there's a lot of them out here. Look at them. I think these are close enough together. I can grab all these real quick here. Let's see. Where? There's one. There's another one. There's another one. 53. We're up to 53. There's two right beside each other. 55. 56. 57. Alright, let's get back in the tractor. There's a couple more over here just to the left. 59. 60. Some down here. Ah. Alright, we're past 70 now. Yeah, I might have should have just went ahead and mowed this whole thing. They're a lot easier to spot out here with the mowed area. There's another one right back here somewhere. Where did I see it? I have to come back. I'm not seeing it now. It's right up there. Alright, we're past 80. I'm jumping, looking for gold. Oh, looks like there's one in that row. Looks like I rode some of them up. Or put the grass on top of them. Alright, I don't know how many we're at now, but we'll look and find the rest here. There's one down here. Alright, we're at 89. There's 90. Alright, we're at 91. There's one down here. Looks like there's several over here on this side. Somewhere. There's one. There's one. 94. Let's see, I think I can. I got them all kind of declustered now. I can kind of walk to them now. Maybe. Straight forward. There's one. Okay, there's one down here. Right there. Alright. Some up around the tractor, and then there's one straight over here. Somewhere. Right there. Alright. Three more, maybe. Yep. Right near our tractor, too. Right there's one. Two more. There's one down here. Right there. And one more. Come on, million. Where's it at? There it is. Found them all. 1 million. All right, we got 1 million in the account, guys. So let's get back down to the farm. We'll come back and pick all this up. Of course, you know, I've done drove across a lot of it and destroyed the crop, so we'll come back and get back to this later, but we want to get our equipment now. So, see, this is a brand new tractor. It doesn't have a lot of hours on it, so, you know what, I'm going to drive down. Can I drive down there? I want to drive down there and just see if there's a gate somewhere down there. I don't think there is, but it sure would make it a lot faster to get back to the farm. No gate. Oh well. There is a road. I wonder if we can take that road. Besides going all the way back around the highway, it might be quicker. Here's that road. Let's see if we can get back around here. It might be quicker. Yeah, this comes right up to our homestead here. So we'll remember to take that dirt road instead of getting out on the highway where all that traffic's at. Of course, I know we can turn traffic off, but, you know, still. Whoa, that was a wrong turn. I should have went that way. All right, now. I think we're good with the current equipment that we have. This vent is okay. It's brand new. The Herleman I just wasn't a fan of, so we won't do the Herleman. We've already got a front loader for this one anyway, so we'll keep it the same. I think I'm going to get rid of the same. Whoa, that had a weird startup sound though. Listen to that. Yeah, I'm going to sell the same. All right. And we'll keep the front loader attachments because what I'm thinking is we're going to start out getting some, let me see. Is there anything in this planter? If it's already got stuff in it, I'll keep it for now. But yeah, it's already got seed in it. So I'm going to keep that planter for now. And I'm going to drive this back to the shop. Is there anything I can haul back, though? Take a look around our implements here. Turn the engine off to save fuel. We'll keep that tipper. That's a Garant manure spreader. Coty. Garant Coty, maybe. Joskin. One of these is a... Okay, this is a slurry... tank there. This is water transport. So this is water transport for the animals. Then our tipper. I kind of want to keep both of those because we're going to need them anyway. Boy, that has a weird startup sound. It's more realistic. It's kind of cool. I might keep this tractor. I don't know. There's our vent. We're going to keep it. Sprayer, what is that? Oh, we can get rid of this baler. This looks like a tedder. That's what that is. That's a tedder. I think it's a small one though. Fennec 604 Vicon. Where are tedders at? Yeah, that's the small one. 6 meter, 12.5, 13, and 8.7 on the coon. We want the Pottinger. So we'll take that up there. We'll go ahead and we'll buy that. And we'll take this tedder and that baler and this tractor. I guess we'll go ahead and get rid of this tractor. That's, I don't know, it might be a good tractor, but same Fortis. Let's just take a look at the numbers on it. It's about a mid-sized tractor, but I don't know. It just doesn't. I don't think I want to keep it. Carry that on the front. Carry the baler on the back. Keep the sprayer. Because if we decide to do 3-stage fertilization, we'll need that sprayer. We've already got a pellet fertilizer. And Lord, I don't want to do this round baler. I would rather have the square baler any day. So we'll take all this up to the shop. And we got a pickup wagon. We'll keep that. It's just a, I think that's a mid-range one. It's not the smallest one. It's not the biggest, but it might work for around here. So we'll hang on to that. What else we got? The JCB skid steer. If I can even get out of here, let me push this plow back a little. It's got a pallet fork on it. I don't know, it might come in handy with the wool pallets. So we'll hang on to it too. Like I said, the cedar and that cultivator. What kind of cultivator is this? It's a Vogel Newt. I've never worked with it, but we'll keep it for now. The plow? I don't know. We may trade in that plow too. But let's go ahead and take this up there while we've got it all hooked up. And the question is, what kind of equipment do we want to get? And if we do, do we want to buy any more fields? And that's another biggie, is the fields. How much do they cost? Well, I can tell you 24 is probably out of the question, because it's a big field and it's probably really expensive. I'm curious to see if all these fields have fences in between them. You know what? Wait a minute. There's a road back there. Come on, round baler. I hate you, but stay on the road. Please open inward. And I knew I wasn't going to make that. Come on. There we go. This is actually a shortcut. I can go to the shop this way. Yeah, this... that's actually part of Field 24, and it is huge. Probably won't be able to get that right away. We probably should start small. Trying to look and see what looks like the smallest field. We've already got 30. That looks like the smallest one. What's the next one? 22 looks like the next smallest one to me. Either 22 or 38. 38's way down there. I'm going to say it's 22. Let's just see how much 22 costs. Well, we can work with them and get the cost down, because that's $114,000. We're going to have to work these fields, guys. We'll get our equipment and work our own fields. But we're going to have to really work these fields for the other farmers in order to be able to buy them. Because they're just too expensive. They want $114,000 for that one little field there. So I'm curious to see how much 24 cost. If that one's $114,000, it must be $1 million or something. And no, I'm not going to spend our million on that. We're going to get some good equipment, and we're going to work our own farm here. Alright, there's our tedder, so we can get some cows. We do need an animal transport trailer too. Alright, I guess I could have shut the engine off. Let's sell this. We're going to need a baler. Sell. I hate that you have to back in and go back into it to sell it. We got $133,000 out of that. Alright. Let's take a look at our garage, what we got. We got the Fendt tractor. It's a nice little tractor, I think. Just for working around the farm, maybe. And we can always sell it later if we want to. The JCB, we'll keep that. Kind of want to keep it on tipper duty because it's so fast, maybe. Or we could put it on logging, either one. Of course, we got our implements here. The JCB, it might be really good for pallets, for sheep or something, so we'll hang on to it. Massey Ferguson, that's a good little combine. We'll keep it. And it's got a 7.6 meter head on it, so that's all right. Since we started with the Massey harvester, we may just start with the Massey team here. And yeah, all these other implements, I think, look okay to keep. Except for the planters. I may go ahead and plant the seed that's in them and trade those in for something else. Matter of fact, I'm probably going to get the horse planters, but yeah, I kind of want to keep, I don't know, the Fendt, we may trade it, go ahead and trade it in, I don't know. The JCB we'll keep. So let's see what we can get here. Tractors. There's the first Massey Ferguson. 87,000. And the first Fendt is 110 horsepower for 111,000. This is 105 horsepower, so it's not that much smaller. The maintenance a day is 120. Maintenance a day is 100 on the Fendt. You know, maintenance a day really is not that big of a deal. And I can upgrade the engine in this to 130. So that'll bring it to 99,000. I'm going to sell the Fendt. I think I've decided. I'm just going to go ahead and sell this Fendt. But not right away. I think I'm going to go ahead and plant. I think we got some fields that need to be planted, and I'm going to use those. I'm going to get my larger tractors first. I'm going to start with the big one. Let's see. What's the biggest Massey? Okay, Valtra. This would actually be a good mowing tractor here because it's got those turf tires, the smoother tires. That's a mod, 220 horsepower for $78,000. That might be worth looking into. It's Russian made, but you can make it any color you want. Might be a nice investment there. The maintenance is a high, kind of 420 a day, but I think some of these others are too. Alright, that's the biggest Massey. 300 horsepower. And you can put twin wheels on it or standard wheel weights, wide tires, twin wheels. We'll probably keep twin wheels on it. It's the black edition, though. You cannot change that color. And actually, you can put a really big engine on it, 400 horsepower. I don't know if that machine will fit through some of the places, though. That's a really big machine. Those twin wheels, I'm not sure that it would fit through some of the roads here. So let me look further down here. There's a big Fendt. These are all special tractors up here. Where's the next Massey Ferguson? There it is. Engine set up. We can put a 400 horsepower engine in it. But a 300 would be enough to pull, I think, both of the horse planters. Because these are the ideal planters here. Yeah, 270 and 180, so we're good to go with that tractor. I'll tell you what, we'll decide this in the next episode and get our new equipment back to the farm. Because we are out of time. I think we're a little over time now. So until then, guys, remember you reap what you sow. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade. We'll see you in the next video.